Morgan Smith there with TXK Marketing. I'm here with the 2019 Stanley Cup champion, Pat Maroon of the St. Louis Blues. A lot of you may not know that we used to have a hockey team right here in Texarkana. Going back, how long ago was that?
14 years ago.
Oh, man. So you played, there were the Texarkana Bandits. Played for the Bandits. From there you went to where?
To there, our team moved to St. Louis. We were still called the Bandits instead of Texarkana, was St. Louis Bandits. And we actually went on to win the North American Hockey League that year. So when our team moved, so Texarkana just missed it.
So, you know, winning the Stanley Cup championship, I'm assuming, man, that just had to be unbelievable. One thing I want to let everybody know, you know, he beat our Stars, scored the game-winning goal as time. There was 2 minutes left in the game, sending the St. Louis Blues all the way to the Stanley Cup Finals. What was that experience like?
Yeah, it was good. Scoring that goal, double overtime against Dallas Stars, and it was truly amazing. Being from St. Louis and putting that jersey on every night, and I always wanted to come home and play in St. Louis, so it's just an accomplishment that I'll never forget. It was a moment for me, my family, my son, my fiance that we'll all cherish for the rest of our lives because we're all St. Louis fans. We were all St. Louis Blues fans growing up. So it was a really neat feeling to bring us to the conference finals. And it was honestly one of the best nights of my life.
That's great. You told me a little bit yesterday playing in the Pro-Am about how you got to spend 12 hours with the Stanley Cup. And, you know, is there anything you did that was really special that, you know, something you just won't forget with your time with it?
I think, yeah, one of the things is, I think just, I mean, there's a couple things I'd like to say, but I think just having my grandma there to have that moment with us, my grandma Maroon, my other three grandparents just passed away, but I know they were there above looking at us, but, you know, seeing my grandma cry and really take that all in and cherish that Stanley Cup meant the world to me and my family, but just having the time to really enjoy it with my fiance and my son and to really take it all in, eating cereal out of it, taking family pictures with the dogs and just really taking the time to look at all the names on the list and having that time with my mom, my dad, my brothers, and my sister. So it was a really memorable night we'll never forget. And it was a great Stanley Cup party. And my fiance's grandpa that's still alive got to really cherish it too. He owns a restaurant, Charlie Gito's, in town. And he got to eat toaster raviolis out of it. So it was a really neat Stanley Cup party.
That's awesome. Pat was nice enough to come back in town for the WAPT and APT events, help raise money for local charities, came to spend some time with the kids, maybe going to play in the shootout this afternoon. You know, I was asking some people around town, like, give me a question I should ask him. And a couple of them that came up, the one is, how hard is it to fight on skates?
It's very hard. I don't recommend if you've never tried it before. pick your spots if you are going to do it. But it's one of those things where, you know, if you skate your whole life, you get so used to it. You never want to see anyone get hurt in a fight. But I've done a lot of fighting in my NHL career, and I plan on hopefully keeping it going, I guess. I like to stick up for my teammates, and sometimes I like to do it just to keep me going.
Yeah, Faye J told me you were the enforcer. Has it been that way on every team or just the Blues?
He told
me you're tough.
I'm tough. I like to fight a little bit, but it's never been in my blood. I've always fought in juniors and all the way up, but I was a point guy. I was a goal scorer. Couldn't believe it, but I was before my time, before I got to the NHL. I had to find a mark in my career. You had to find a knack how to make it to the next level, because when you get all these points in juniors and the minors and the American League, you got to find a way why you're not making it. And I just started fighting a little more and trying to find a way to get respect around the league. And, you know, that's what I started to do.
That's great. We really appreciate you coming back to Texarkana, spending this time with us, doing everything you're doing for this community here. You know, Faye J. Durant was one of the leads, Mr. Ledwell, bringing you back. But we appreciate you spending time in your off season coming and seeing us. Good luck next year. Can you give us any insight where you may land?
I don't know anything right now. Just a lot of interest right now, so we just got to find ways to what's the best fit for me right now, you know, if it's a one-year deal, two-year deal, but you just got to find ways to make it the best fit for yourself. But I'll go anywhere right now. I'm ready to go anywhere and just kind of prove people wrong again, what they're missing out on again. But I would like to take time to thank Faye J. Norma for bringing me back into Texarkana. I told them when he first picked me up, I never thought I'd come back here again. So they've done a lot for me and my family, and certainly everyone around Texarkana and the community. And for me to come back and give back for him, just to see what he has done in this community, it really means a lot to us. So when I got the call, it was a no-brainer, and certainly I wanted to show my fiance Francesca and Anthony, my son, really kind of what this city's about. And you know, Faye Jane Omer's done a good job, so I'm happy to be back.
All right. Appreciate your time. 2019 Stanley Cup champion Pat Maroon.